Stacie Orrico is one of the most talented singers of the industry. She cannot just sing, she can write, can play instruments, and she is a good actor. She started singing when she was a young girl, but she never had the attention to become a superstar or a worldwide known singer. She was singing just for fun, in the church, with her family, without knowing that she got something special inside of her. As a teenager, she became a part of a singing talent show, and she won the show. Music executive from the label Forefront Records saw her on their talent show and was interested to sign her. She recorded her first album and released it in 2000 with the title Genuine. In his first week, the album sold more than 30,000 units, the highest debut week sales ever for a female Christian artist. It produced hit singles like Genuine and Don't Look at Me, which became a number one hit single in the Christian singer chart.
Don't speak about it, think about it, be about it. Gotta make yourself aware that you're gonna stray. You're trying so hard to fit in.
The focus for the second album was to stay Christian, but to focus a little bit more on the mainstream audience. With her first album, she had massive success. She sold more than 500,000 units and gained gold. At that time, mainstream audience were not playing her music. MTV and all the big music platforms were not playing her music. Just the pop radio station. And to achieve something like that without all the big platforms, that's huge. So for the second album, she was with Forefront, but she signed also a deal with Virgin Records. They had the goal to make it bigger than she was before. This time around, she had all the huge platforms, like radios, like big TV shows. They wanted to do everything possible to break her into the mainstream. Her first single for the second album was Stuck. It was her first song which charted on the Billboard 100 charts on number 52. Internationally, it became a huge hit. Although she was already known in the Christian community and had already huge hits with her albums and singles, most people started to notice her after she had her super huge hit single Stuck.
You know what I'm saying, you know what I mean, yeah. Every now and then, when I'm all alone, I've been wishing you would call me on the telephone. Say you want me back, but you never do. I feel like such a fool. I can't stop thinking of
outside of America, the song became a huge top 10 singer. In Japan, it charted on number 1. The song gained certain certifications from different countries. Her second album was a self-titled album which she released in 2003. It became a success all around the world. She did get a lot of certifications, including in America, for selling more than 500,000 units. In the US, she was certified with a gold certification. Her second single for the album became a bigger hit than her first single Stuck. There's Gonna Be More to Life charted at number 13 on the Billboard 100 charts and became a massive hit internationally. Stuck and More to Life became one of her most significant songs that she released. She started to tour around the whole world to promote songs, to promote her albums, to connect with her fans, but she realized that she started to lose the connection to God. For Stacie, faith played always a huge part in her life. Also, she started to lose the interest in performing and in touring because she started to feel like the industry is very dark and very lonely and it has too much to do with business. Industry life started to get exhausting for her, all the question, all the celebrity stuff, because she was never the type of person that liked gossip, that liked the paparazzi life, the girl who likes hanging up in clubs and do everyday party, but that was the type of life that her label and some of her team expected her to have. For them it was like, that makes you more interesting, and if you do stuff like that, people gonna buy your records. But she wanted to stay true to herself, true to her faith, and build a stronger connection to God. Also, she felt like she's missing so many things back home. Industry tried to shift her. They tried to change her. They wanted her to be more naked, to show more skin. That was not what she wanted to. She just wanted to make music, touch people's hearts, make money from her music, live from her music, and enjoy life. But she felt like the industry tried to interrupt the peace that she was trying to find for herself. So after touring and having concerts, she said to a record label that she wants time and more experience to find herself as a person, as a musician, to recreate her music. So she spent a lot of time with her family, lived a normal life. She tried to distance herself more from the music industry. After a certain time, she started to get back into the studio and write some things out. She did not even tell her label that she started to work on a third album because she didn't want them to tell her what she had to do. Because in that era, electro pop music was coming. Labels are never interested in your artistry. They just want you to jump on the next hype and to get them the next number one single or album. She started to work in silence on a third album. She flew often to Atlanta and worked with people like Dallas Austin, who was also the producer of the major group TLC, and she worked also with Shakespeare, who produced No Scrubs. For this record, she wanted more soul R&B vibe because she grew up listening to all the soul singers from Nina Simone to Lauryn Hill, Monica, Crystal Lewis, Whitney Houston, Mariah Carey, Destiny's Child, and she wanted to include that more in her music. I'm Not Missing You was the first single of the album that she released in 2006, but it did not chart on the Billboard 100 charts, but outside of America it charted well.
I hate to see you gone, but this time it's different. I don't even feel the distance. I'm not missing you. I'm not going through the motions, waiting and hoping you call me. I'm not missing you. You gotta have me open, but I must be going because I got life to do. I know I'm usually hanging out. I used to hate to see you gone, but this time it's different. I don't even feel the distance. I'm not missing.
I'm not missing you.
No, I can't be with you, cause I'm scared. Felt like I was falling when you left me. I can't keep going through life unaware of what I miss, nor the person I could be. Love's good when it's right, bad when it's left, and your memory always has a pleasure time. I guess love would be nice for someone else's life. I'm not missing you.
Before she released the album, it was leaked. Most of the songs was already on the internet. On August 14, 2006, the label Virgin released the final album Beautiful Awakening. They released it in some countries outside of America, but in America they didn't release it. Second single for the album was So Simple, but they did not put much input to the single to promote it. It seemed like the label lost the interest in her. I think they wanted it to be more messy, more loud, more crazy, more drunk. The girl who is on every aftershow party, but she was not like that. So I think that's one of the reasons why they stopped supporting her music. All of her albums are really great, and you can hear that she improved with every album. What I personally love about her music is she makes people think when she sings. She was talking about life, she was not talking crap like most of the musicians today. Her music had substance, and The Beautiful Awakening is 100% the best album. I think the album had a lot of potential to become really big, because that album was better than the previous album. But the label wanted to stop her career because she is a normal girl, she's a Christian girl, she has Christian morals, and for them it was too boring to have someone like her. Because after the third album she had some shows, and then she disappeared for a very long time. She wrote some records for some huge music artists in the industry like Fantasia and a couple other artists, but she never tried to enter the music industry like before. In 2014 she released her independent EP Reawaked, but Stacie disappeared from the industry totally. In my opinion, she is a true artist because she made timeless records. Every album of her is timeless. Touches your heart, it touches your soul, and the topics fits to every generation. It's something that little girls can listen to, little boys can listen to, adults can listen to, because everyone can listen to her music and learn something. Songs like More to Life, With a Little Faith, Tight, It Is Me, and much more. She created masterpieces. Her music is really, really great, and she reminds me a little bit of Sade, of Lauryn Hill, because she's one of those artists who care about her art. She's not there to live the celebrity life. You want to create something great to share that with the world. And not a lot of musicians are like that these days. I saw a video of a YouTuber and she told a story that she met Stacie some months ago, and she talked about her and especially about music, and she asked her why she disappeared from music so long and if she ever will return to music. And she said the music industry changed so much and she don't like the politics behind the music industry. Everything is about business, about charts, about number one, about clothing, about being successful, and she just wants to do music and she don't know if it makes sense to come back or if enough people are there to listen to her music. I think a lot of people are missing her, including me. Like, she's a great musician, she can sing her face off, she has a complete own sound, and people want to see her again releasing albums, performing on stage, go on tours. And I think what people like the most about her is she never changed, she stayed true to herself. Today Stacie is married with Isaiah Johnson and they share two kids with each other. I knew Stacie from back in the day, like Stuck and More to Life were huge hits here in Europe. When it first came out, they was playing it all the time on TV, on radio, etc. I was listening to the songs, but I was not a huge fan and I did not understand what she was saying. I was too young at that time. So during the pandemic, I was listening to Christian songs and I was looking for new Christian artists for my playlist, and I found her, and then I started to listening her whole albums and I realized what type of an amazing artist she is. So that's crazy to think that she thinks that people don't want her music or don't want her anymore, because she is great and I hope she will make one day a comeback. I hope you liked the video. When yes, leave me a thumb up, subscribe my channel to don't miss any other videos. When you want to know what happened to Andrea Fimbres, the ex-member of the successful girl group Danity Kane, which also reminds me a lot of Stacie Orrico, and watch the next video. We see each other next time. Bye.